Hello, Flower on Fish enthusiasts. Today, we are diving deep into a topic that is often debated among fish keepers. Should you really feed live food to your flower on fish? Flower ons are known for their vibrant colors and unique head shapes, making them a favorite among hobbies. But when it comes to their diet, there is a lot to consider. So in this video, we will explore the pros and cons of feeding live food, ensuring you have all the knowledge you need to make the best decision for your flower on's health and happiness. So, let's get started. So, first is understanding flower on fish diet. Before we delve into live food, it's crucial to understand the dietary needs of your flower-on fish. In the wild, flower-ons are omnivorous, consuming a variety of foods, including smaller fish, insects, and plant matter. Their diet should be high in protein to support their rapid growth and vibrant coloration. A balanced diet is essential for their overall health, helping them to thrive and display their best colors. So, what role does live food play in meeting these nutritional needs? Second is type of live food for flower on fish. Now, let's talk about the live food available of different types you can offer to your flower on. Some popular options include small fish like guppies or minnows, crickets, mealworms and other insects, earthworms and bloodworms, small shrimps and crayfish. Each type of live food offers unique nutritional benefits. For instance, feeder fish are rich in protein while insects provide essential fats and vitamins. However, it's crucial to source these live foods from reputable suppliers to avoid introducing disease or parasites into your aquarium. Third is benefits of feeding live food. Feeding live food has several advantages. First, it's highly nutritious, packed with proteins and essential nutrients that can enhance your flower-on's growth and coloration. Second, live food stimulates the natural hunting instincts of your fish, providing both mental and physical enrichment. Third, it adds variety to their diet, preventing dietary monotony. And finally, many aquarists report that live food can lead to improved health and vitality in their flower-ons. Fourth is risk and drawbacks of feeding live food. However, feeding live food is not without its risk. One major concern is the potential for diseases and parasite transmission. Live food can carry harmful pathogens that may infect your flower on. To mitigate this, always quarantine and treat live food before feeding it to your fish. Another risk is nutritional imbalance. Overfeeding live food can lead to health issues like obesity. Additionally, live food can sometimes cause aggression and stress, especially if your flower-on competes with tank mates. Lastly, there are ethical considerations regarding the welfare of feeder animals. Fifth is safe practices for feeding live food. To safely feed live food to your flower-on, follow these best practices. First one is quarantine and treat. Isolate live food for a period and treat it to eliminate any potential pathogens. Second is source from reputable suppliers. Ensure the quality and safety of the live food by buying from trusted suppliers. Third is proper feeding techniques. introduce live food to the tank in a way that minimizes stress and aggression. Fourth is monitor fish health. Regularly observe your flowron for any signs of illness or stress and adjust their diet as needed. Six is alternatives to live food. If you are concerned about the risk of live food, there are excellent alternatives available. High quality pellets are formulated to meet the nutritional needs of flowron fish and are a convenient option. Frozen and freeze-dried foods offer the benefits of live food without the risk of disease. You can also prepare homemade fish food to ensure a balanced diet. Combining these options with occasional live food can provide a varied and nutritional diet for your flowron. Seventh is practical tips and recommendations. So, here are some practical tips for feeding your flowron. First is balanced feeding schedule. Create a feeding schedule that balances live food with high quality pellets and other options. Second is gradual introduction. Introduce live food slowly to avoid stressing your fish. Third is regular health checkups. Keep an eye on your flowron's health and make adjustments as necessary. Fourth is troubleshooting. Address any feeding problems promptly to maintain your fish well-being. You can call us at any time. We are always available and happy to help you. So, concluding this. In conclusion, feeding live food to your flowron fish can offer significant benefits but also comes with risk. By following safe practices and balancing live food with other dietary options, you can provide a nutritious and varied diet for your fish. Remember, every flowron is unique, so observe your fish and adjust their diet to meet their specific needs. So, thank you for watching. If you found this video helpful, please like, share and subscribe for more fish care tips and advice. See you next time. So friends, thanks for tuning in. If you have any questions or want to share your experience, drop a comment below. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more informative videos on fish care. Check out our other videos available on our channel. Until next time, happy fish keeping!